Everyone, so today I'm going to be showing you the new Sigma Born to Be collection. I got this collection because when I saw what was all included, I thought that it would be the ideal nude lover makeup collection. So let me show you a little bit. When you open it up, you actually get it in this beautiful packaging showing the model up there with actually really nice makeup. And you get the eyeshadow palette, three eyeliners, the concealer, the blush, and three lip glosses. So now instead of doing a classical review, what I decided to do is actually build a look using the eyeshadow palette and every other product which is within the set. I'm gonna be using this palette from the collection, and inside the collection you get 12 eyeshadow palettes, and it says that the net weight is 12 grams, so I'm assuming that all together the eyeshadows contain 12 grams. You get a mirror inside, and then you get these beautiful shades which I have swatched, and on my website there will be a swatch of each individual shade. I'm just gonna show you one, for example the blue one. Look how well pigmented it is. And let's say the black one. All right, the next thing inside the collection is this loose hollow lip concealer. I love the hollow effect. And it's a lip concealer that reminds me of a peachy concealer. I haven't tried it underneath my eyes, but I will be using it as an eyeshadow base today, and I will be applying it on my lips just to kind of get a feeling of it. You also get a blush inside. It's the Born to Powder blush. Realistically, when you first look at it, it looks pretty dark, but this, I'm telling you, after I swatched it, I did wear it automatically. This is a beautiful shade for fair to light skin tones, maybe even medium, because it's actually a buildable shade. Are these three lip glosses. This one and one here, right here, grabbed my attention automatically just because it's like a peachy nude lip gloss with golden sparkles. I will have a very zoomed in picture of how it looks, and it's called Get Ready Lip Gloss. The other fun color, I mean, this is so much fun, is the Even Lip Gloss collect, a lip gloss. And the last one is called Sheila Lip Gloss. It's, again, a beautiful shade. I think that these are really three fun shades which you can wear a lot. And last but not least are the three liners. All right, the very blue liner, which is amazing. I'm just going to show you, I'm going to show you a swatch of it. I have my hand right here. There you go. It's extremely blue. And let me see, this one is called Atomic Number 6. I think it's like a very dark brown. It looks kind of black, but it's a very dark brown. And this one is a beautiful medium blue. Look at those colors. Amazing. To apply my makeup, I'm actually going to be using my new makeup brush collection, the Sigma Copper. It's the professional blush collection. I'm going to be making a specific video about this collection and why I personally love it and why I decided to buy it. Alright, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my loose hollow lip concealer, and I'm going to be taking my Sigma concealer brush in F70. I think this is a very nice brush, not only for applying like concealers, but it's also a really beautiful blush for like neutralizing and for an eye base. And in this way I'm going to be neutralizing any redness, and it's going to be a really nice eyeshadow base. This is the first time I'm actually using it. But yeah, hopefully it's gonna do what I think it will do. So the first thing I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be taking the shade called Veiled. This is that shade. It's actually a matte shade. I'm going to be applying it into my crease and just blending it upwards towards my eyebrows. I'm sorry, I forgot to mention the brush that I'm using. I'm using the medium angled shading brush in E70. I'm going to be taking the shade called Thunderhead, this shade right here, and I'm going to be taking Sigma's brush E55. It's the classic shader brush. I'm going to be picking up a little bit, tapping off any excess, and then just lightly apply it right there. Now, with that same E shader brush, I'm going to be taking the shade right here, Rave. I'm going to be applying this on the inner third part of my eye. I'm going to be taking Haze. It's a very similar tone to the purple one. It's like in the purple family. Let's see. I'm just gonna be applying it out here. I'm blending it into the purple. If the purple shade seems a little bit too pale, maybe a wider base would have been better, because I want it to be a little bit more noticeable. I picked up a larger amount, and then I'm gonna pick up Yale and apply it over. Now you can go back to this brush right here, the shader brush in E70, and just take it and blend these two harsh lines. I'm just gonna lightly use it to blend. So now I'm going to be taking this sparkly shade here, it's called Rave. Applying that over that eyeshadow, I think it was called Haze, which we applied earlier. Just dabbing. I like it because I think it's a little bit darker and it's going to be a little bit more complementary. And just make sure to blend between these two shades. And I love how it's glittery. Look at that. Now I'm going to be taking the shade right here. It's called Cinders, I think. And I'm going to be taking my Sigma brush in E30. And I'm just going to be defining my outer V. To blend any harsh lines, I'm taking E45. It's a pointy blending brush. I really like that. And I'm just going to be blending that line into the crease, which I applied. I'm going to be picking up the shade called Rave. It's that one right there with my short shader brush, E20. I'm just going to be applying it like right there. And now I'm going to be taking the dark gray eyeshadow, and I'm going to be applying it right there. Okay, so I'm going to be using the Sigma shade in Atomic number 6. It's a dark brown, and I'm going to be applying it on my waterline. Okay, I'm going to be taking the small angled brush in E65, and I'm going to be taking that makeup. So now that I managed to apply that, I'm going to be setting it because it's very creamy pencil. I'm going to be taking just a little bit of Almost Jet and a lot of that other shade because I'm trying to make a dark brown. And I'm just going to be applying it over that. Now to apply this blush, the shade Born 2, as I said, it's a beautiful shade for fair, light, and some medium shades. I'm going to be taking my Sigma powder brush in F10, tap it off the excess, and just lightly apply it. So now I'm going to be applying this nude shade on my lips. Copper palette, I'm going to be taking the lip pencil. It looks like a blip. Pop it open like that. And I'm going to be picking up that concealer, just a very light coat, and just applying it on my entire lip. As you can see, it neutralizes the natural redness in my lip. So the next step is taking a lip gloss. I'm going to be taking First, I'm going to try the Get Ready With Me lip gloss because it has a little bit gold undertone and I thought it would look really nice. These two make a really nice nude lip color. It might look a little bit too nude, right? I'm going to be taking this shade in Sheila. This looks great on my lips, but for this look, I think I prefer the more very nude look. I don't know which you liked. I'll leave a comment below telling me, did you like more the nude lips or these pinky natural nude lips? I like both, and I just think that this shade looks more natural on me than the other pure nude one. But for this look up here, I think that the pure nude look was a little bit more appealing and a little bit more color correct, let's put it like that. But then again, that was just my opinion. So if you think the look is too nude, go back to that holo concealer dab a little bit, sorry if you think it's too pink, dab a little bit of that concealer over, and you're going to brighten up the lip gloss. So for my fake lashes, I'm going to be applying Artists of Makeup Sucreate Cosmetics Iconic Lashes in Hepburn. If you want to see a review of her entire collection of eyelashes, make sure to click here. It's going to be popping up where you can actually see me review all of her 6 eyelashes. All right, everyone, that completes the look. I just wanted to add a little bit more information. Maybe you have noticed that my face is a little bit more shaded and contoured. And the reason is because I did contour and highlight my face. These 2 brushes, the tapered face brush and F25, have come in very handy for my contouring and highlighting. Don't forget to like this video, leave a comment below commenting which lips you preferred, and maybe if you want to see some other makeup looks done with this makeup palette. I think it's a beautiful palette with a lot of nudes. If you're interested in another look, please make sure to check which shades are within the palette and just tell me which shades you would like to see some maybe future tutorial.